Thank you for flying in.
You believe. the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Clearly, this is not a good
Yes, he's not.
Dear brothers and sisters, first, sorry for the late start. We had a little time mix up, but we are here, so we thank the Lord. As some of you may have heard by now, Bishop Burns, our bishop, who was supposed to be here with us today to celebrate this Mass, lost his mother on Tuesday night, and so had to return home to Pittsburgh for the funeral. And so the bishop, in his love and kindness towards our community, especially the fact that this whole community gathering today was his idea, sent his personal delegate, Father Arthur Unachuku, who is our associate vicar for clergy, to represent him here today and to inaugurate this Cameroonian Catholic community. So Father Arthur, we thank you very much for accepting this assignment.
Thank you.
And we also thank Father Andrew Simler, our pastor here at St. Jude, for graciously opening his doors to us. And Father Andrew has always been a great friend of the Cameroonian community and the whole African community in total. And so, Father Andrew, we thank you for your graciousness and your hospitality.
Thank you, Father Andrew.
My sisters and my brothers, you definitely got the short end of the stick. I promise you that, okay? That bishop was supposed to be here and he's not. He sent me instead, huh? I know you were looking forward to it, and I too am disappointed because I was looking forward to it myself. But now here we are. And so, dear friends, we come together around this altar, for this altar is what unites us together as Catholics. No matter where we come from, we always recognize the altar of the Lord, the Holy Eucharist. And so before we start, as we begin this inaugural Mass, for the Cameroonian community. So we pause now, pray for the forgiveness of our sins.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that
I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. To my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. O God, who calls the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promised, that amid the uncertainties of this life, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please remain standing.
God, give me my heart.
A reading from the book of Joshua. Joshua gathered together all the tribes at Shechem, summoning their elders, their leaders, their judges, and their officers. When they stood in ranks before God, Joshua addressed all the people. If it does not please you to serve the Lord, decide today whom you will serve. The gods your father served beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose country you are now dwelling. As for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. But the people answered, far be it from us to forsake the Lord for the service of other gods. For it was the Lord, our God, who brought us and our fathers up out of the land of Egypt, out of a state of slavery. He performed those great miracles before our very eyes and protected us along our entire journey and among the peoples through whom we passed. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm.
The response is, taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
Taste and see.
The Lord has eyes for the just and ears for their cry. The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
When the just cry out, the Lord hears them. And from all their distress, he rescues them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit, he saves.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Many are the troubles of the just one, but out of them all, the Lord delivers him. He watches over all his bones. Not one of them shall be broken.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Second reading. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, live in love as Christ loved us. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and handed himself over for her to sanctify her, cleansing her by the bath of water with the word, that he might present himself to the church in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. So also, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one hates his own flesh, but rather nourishes and cherishes it, as even Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one. This is a great mystery, but I speak in reference to Christ and the church. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, Lord.
Many of Jesus' disciples who were listening said, "This saying is hard. Who can accept it?" Since Jesus knew that his disciples were murmuring about this, he said to them, "Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life, while the flesh is of no avail. The words I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But there are some of you who do not believe." Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe and the one who would betray him. And he said, "For this reason, I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." As a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their former way of life and no longer accompanied him. Jesus then said to the 12, "Do you also want to leave?" Simon Peter answered him, "Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Is this a Cameroonian Catholic community?
Yes, yes.
I can hear you.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
Is this a Cameroonian Catholic community?
Yes.
My brothers and my sisters, congratulations to all of you.
Thank you.
Congratulations to all of you. This is indeed a day of great joy, isn't it?
Yes.
You have done it, huh?
Yes.
You have done it. You have come together as a family, as a community, to establish for yourselves a place to call home. Isn't it exciting, though, you know, when the gospel, the dance, and the gospel is coming down the aisle? Didn't it take you all the way back home? And the way you grew up, and all the senses, the beauty of just home coming back to you? You know, I just felt like transported back to Nigeria, even though that's not part of what we do, but I was like, wow. Right? There is something about being able to worship in your tongue, in your language, in your own way of living, just the way you grew up. That's the way God always wanted it. That is the whole mystery of the incarnation, isn't it? That Christ came like one of us. He took flesh and became like one of us and incorporated himself into every culture, into every tongue, into every tribe, into every nation, that we may see him as we are. And that is why it's so important for us to establish this community, so we may worship just the way God has given it to us. Amen?
Amen.
You know, it is really sad that His Excellency Bishop Burns is not here today. I tell you, he was looking forward to this day. He was looking forward to it. He spoke of it often. He made sure it was on my calendar. He wanted to be here and to celebrate with all of you because he had made it one of his top priorities to encourage, to nurture, and to preserve every culture in the diocese. He travels from every community to the other, so that he may bind himself closely to those communities and to them to know that even though they may come from far, the thing that unites us, the one person that unites us, is our faith and Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Has always been that way. From beginning of time, whenever immigration started, people began to migrate from one country to another. People always went with their faith. Think about it. When the Italians moved, they moved with their priest. You go to New York, you see Italian churches, because they worshiped in their tongue the way they know how to worship. Then the Irish, they came with their own priest. The Polish, they came with their own priest. The Germans, with their own priest. They all came from far to a new country, but they knew the only thing that would sustain them in that new country is their faith and the Holy Eucharist. Amen?
Amen.
And it is the same now. It has never changed. For every culture is tethered, every culture is bound together with their faith and their worship. You can't really tease it apart. Faith and culture has always lived together as brothers and sisters, always informing each other, elevating each other, and helping each other become perfect in the eyes of God. It has always been that way. And here you are today, the inaugural mass for the Cameroonian community in DFW. Yours is not gonna be different, huh? Yours is not going to be a different story, huh? It's going to be the story that we know, that your faith is expressed in your culture. Amen?
Amen.
And here we are. Here we are. The readings today could not be perfect. Could no more be perfect. The first reading from the book of Joshua. The people of God, having been rescued from Egypt into the land of promise. They've come a long way to a land of promise. And there they were. And Joshua knew that the people might begin to drift to other distractions, to other ways of life, to other lesser gods. So Joshua called the people together and said, look, I'm gonna let you have it the way you all want it. If you want to serve the God who brought you from the land of Egypt into the promised land, choose for yourselves today. But if you want to go on with the distractions of this new place, If you want to follow the gods of the Amorites, that's yours. You can do that too. But I and my household has decided that today we are going to worship the living God. That's what he said to them. Because he knew. Happens to every one of us. Some of you already seen that in your kids, huh? They begin to drift. They go this way and that way. Sometimes even you go that way or this way. Distractions. And the way you were brought up, and the values and the faith and the religion that was given to you, almost being attacked. Not always in a negative sense, but you have to wonder, you have to try to preserve the identity that you brought from back home. And Joshua left it for them that way. But the gospel is where I'm going to stop. Because the gospel perhaps will leave your community with something to hold on to, the Eucharist. Something you can come back to and go out from, the Lord Jesus Christ. Because the Jesus in Cameroon is the Jesus, is the same Jesus here, amen?
Amen.
Is that same Lord who brought you from the land of Cameroon to here that you may prosper and have a new life, but never forgetting your Lord. So Jesus been going through John chapter 6 for the past 4 weeks now, reading this expose, discourse on the Eucharist, on Jesus giving us his body and blood. And this comes the final chapter, the final verses of that chapter. If you remember, the chapter began with the multiplication of loaves. The people got hungry, they followed Jesus around, and Jesus, having compassion on them, says, hey, let's feed them. Let's give them food. And so Philip provides bread and fish, and Jesus blesses it and gives it to the people. And they ate, and scripture says they were content. They were satisfied. So the next week, what happened? They went looking for Jesus. I mean, who wouldn't? If you know where to find your bread, why work? Just go to Jesus, he'll make you more bread. And so they went back to Jesus, and Jesus said, you guys are coming not because of me, but because of the bread I gave you, isn't it? And Jesus said, well, if you want this bread that I gave you a bread and you're still hungry. But let me give you a bread that if you eat this bread, you would never hunger and you would never die. So they said to Jesus, wow, give us this bread then. Give it to us. We will eat and we will never hunger. We will never work. We will never die. Give us this food. So Jesus said, well, the bread that I will give you is my flesh for the life of the world. They said, say what? He said, I will give you my flesh. And the Greek word is like, the body of an animal. I will give that to you to eat. And then you will drink my blood. Now remember, this is the Jewish people. Blood is sacred to the Lord. And you don't mess with blood. Blood belongs to the Lord. You don't touch blood. It can make you unclean, actually. Jesus says, you will eat my flesh and drink my blood. In Nigeria, they'll say, Biko Kwao. Where does one come from? Abego. So they say, Jesus, what are you talking about? To eat your flesh and to drink your blood. Are you kidding us? Jesus says, I'm not kidding, you know. I'm not kidding, you know. He doubled down. He said, unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you will not have life in me. You will not live forever. Ha ha. And the way you go say, ha, why come to yourself? So then the people say, I know to go. So the gospel today says many of his disciples who are listening to Jesus said, this teaching is very hard. Who can accept this kind of teaching? As a result of this teaching, many of his disciples returned to their former ways of life and stopped accompanying Jesus. What in the world? I'm going back.
They left Jesus and went back. You know, when I look at the people several weeks back, when they were going to Jesus for bread, there is always something in every human heart that desires to be satisfied. There is always this emptiness in our hearts, this desire to know the meaning of life, to find fulfillment, to find happiness. There's this thing about completion in our life. We hunger, we thirst for it. And sometimes we go to Jesus looking for it, but we don't really always know what it is that we're looking for. So when they went a few weeks ago, they thought it was bread that they can eat and hunger after the next moment. But Jesus knew in the depths of their heart, it wasn't bread that they hungered for. It was something much deeper. It was He Himself that they hungered. It was the living bread that satisfies all hunger and quenches all thirst. That was what they were looking for. And Jesus wanted to give it to them. And if they have done it, and it just breaks my heart, because these people, they were so close to the satisfaction of all desires. They were so close to the completion of all thirst. But because it was difficult, they turned their back to the Lord and left. They were so close, so close. But because it was hard, they went the other way. Isn't that what we see sometimes in addiction? See somebody who's addicted to something, and they're going through some cleansing, some healing, and then it gets tough. It gets really tough. And they say, I can't go anymore. I'd rather go back. At least I know what addiction was. I can control that. I know what it is. That's why they went back to their former ways. Let me go to my former ways. At least I know what it is. This new teaching, I don't know what it is. Human nature, when it gets tough, we turn around and go back to something always less than God. Always we do that. But for those who have courage to take the next stride, to take the next step, they always discover something beautiful. They discover happiness, the meaning of life, and purpose on earth. The gospel today, my dear friends, is something I hope you will keep in the midst of your community. That when the going gets tough, do not go back. When the infighting begins, do not go back. When the shouting begins, don't go back. Remember why you're here. You came for the Lord Jesus Christ and no one else. He is the one that satisfies every hunger and every thirst. And that's why you came. There's no other. He didn't come here for status. Who is chief and who is less and who is... He didn't come here for that. You came because you're looking for the Lord. And here it is, to satisfy your every hunger and that of your family. And so you bring your family, your sons and your daughters, you bring them before the Lord, before the Eucharist, so that He will give them meaning and purpose. People spend a lot of money and time looking for meaning when everything else is on the altar. And I leave this last thought with you. In the book of Revelation, chapter 5, there He was, the meaning of life, the meaning of every community, the meaning of every culture. John saw the vision in heaven. And he sees the vision, he sees a scroll like this, a book. But the book has seven seals on them. Seven seals. But there was something written in the book that contains the history of humanity, that contains John's own story. The story of every person. The story of the Nigerians and the Cameroonians was contained in the book. And John wanted to see what it was, to read it, so he may find the meaning of life. He may find satisfaction and joy. But no one could be found in heaven and under the heaven to open the book. So John wept. Who can open this book so I can understand and finally find my happiness? The elder touched John and said, weep no more, for we have found the one who can open the book and break open the seal? And he says in Revelation chapter 5, he says, the Lion of Judah, the Root of David, has been found worthy to open the scroll. So John looked up into heaven, and around the throne, what does he see? He sees a lamb, slain, as it were, with the seven marks of slaughter on him. And only the lamb was able to open the book. My dear friends, if you want to know the history of your people, the Eucharist, the Lamb of God on the altar, is the one who holds our history, our tradition, and our culture. Amen?
Amen.
Do you want to understand it? Draw close to the altar. The Lamb is in the middle of the altar. In a little while, we'll hold out the host and say, this is the Lamb of God. The same Lamb that opened the book can open and unlock your life's happiness. He can unlock your mission. He can unlock the history and your story. Only those with courage take the stride to get closer. It will be tough, but when you come, he satisfies all longing. Jesus is amazing, I tell you. Jesus is amazing. The same Lord you worshiped as you grew up is the same Lord here. He would not disappoint you. He will follow you. And he has blessed your community in a special way, because from you have come a priest of Jesus Christ. You have your own priest now. Father Desmond came from your community. He came from your community. He is the answer to many prayers. He is now part of your story. He's now part of your history. Something to be grateful for and to give thanks to the Lord. Now, he doesn't belong to you guys alone, no. He belongs to the bishop, no? So wherever the bishop asks him to go, he will go. But every community is shown how blessed they are by God multiplying vocations within them and members and disciples. So yours is on the way. Yours is upward, and God will be with you as long as you have the courage to continue to return to this altar. So the Lamb of God will unlock your happiness, your future, your story, and the history of the Cameroonian community in DFW. Amen?
Amen.
Of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We praise God for his wisdom that is beyond our understanding, but we all cannot ask him for all our needs because he participates in our purposes.
For Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, that they may use the power of the keys wisely according to God's plan, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who accept the burden of public office, that the powers of evil may not prevail over them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those living with disabilities, that they may not be pushed aside, overlooked, or underestimated, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the Cameroonian community, that we may grow in faith, love, and charity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For growth in priestly vocation and vocation to the religious life in the Diocese of Dallas, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who are sick, that they may know the healing mercy of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the souls of the faithful departed, that the merciful love of the Lord may cleanse and perfect them, especially those we have lost this past year, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Lord, hear our prayers.
Of all wisdom, you instructed your power to your church. As we offer these prayers, help us to fulfill your plan. We are sent through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Alimio veyandimi alimino tata alimio veyandimi alimino
Yeah.
My God, accept my heart this day.
And let it
pray, my brothers and my sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is good and right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For you love us so much that you, in your mercy, you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you love your only begotten Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks. As an exaltation, together we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus,
Sanctus. Yeah.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection.
Christ has died, Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. Christ has died, Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
He will come again.
He will come again. He will come again. He will come again.
He will come again.
He will come again. He will come again. He will come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Jude and with all the saints, on his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help.
There is sacrifice of our reconciliation we pray, O Lord. Advance the peace and salvation of all the world. We please to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim thought on earth with your servant, Francis Apollo, Edward Abbeca, Gregory of Claribel, the order of bishops, all the clergy and entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayer of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, who are departed brothers and sisters, and all who have pleasing to you as they are passing from this land. Give kind admission to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. To kind travel, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Please stand. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Pater noster qui es in celis,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
adveniat regnum tuum,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
fiat voluntas tua,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
sicut in cielo et in terra,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
panem nostrum quotidianum,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
da nobis odie,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
et dimitte nobis debita nostra,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
sicut et nos dimittimus,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
debitoribus nostris,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
et ne nos inducas,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
in tentationem,
sanctificetur nomen tuum,
sed libera nos a malo,
sanctificetur nomen tuum.
Amen, amen, amen,
sanctificetur nomen tuum.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
In secula, in secula, sanctificetur nomen tuum.
For Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. Sacrament, we thee adore.
Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for a few announcements.
Thank you once more for this wonderful liturgy, the wonderful homily. I have a 6 p.m. mass, so I'll just copy a lot of what you say. And again, Father Andrew, thank you so much for opening your doors to us. I would like to thank everybody who made this liturgy possible. Our mothers from the Catholic Women's Association, they have been practicing for a long time. So thank you all so much. And the Shessons, who they flew in their organist. And the Lessons and Upsons and Sobans, who are all here. And all of you, thank you so much for coming out. We will be in touch with you about the date for the next gathering, which will be next month. For all the rest of the St. Jude community and our Dalsan community that joined us at this liturgy today, thank you so much for coming. And for the brother priests who are all here, thank you so much for coming to support this community. Father Jacob Dankasa, who is the administrator at Holy Family in Irving, has been like a spiritual father to our community. And along with Bishop Burns, Father Jacob has been one of those pushing this idea of a Cameroonian Catholic community. And Father Jacob is the chaplain of the Nigerian Catholic community here in the diocese. Father Jacob, thank you so much. Father Jovita Okoli, who is the administrator at All Saints Catholic Church in Dallas. Father, thank you for joining us. And you all know Father Patrick Olaleye.
Yes.
Father Patrick is the administrator at St. Martin of Tours in Forney. And Father Simeon, who is one of yours here, the parochial vicar here, thank you for being here, Father. Father Frank he is the parochial vicar at Mary Immaculate Catholic Church in Farmers Branch. Thank you for being here, Father. And then we have Father Bartholomew, who is the parochial vicar at St. Gabriel's Catholic Church in McKinney. So he and I didn't have to drive too far. And Father Robinson out in Rolette. Sacred Heart Catholic Church in Rolette. Father Robinson is the parochial vicar. Thank you for being here, Father. Father John from St. Francis of Assisi in Frisco. Your parishioners are there. And my classmate and a fellow Shesan, Father Rigo Azanui, OFM cap. He reminds me to put the cap every time I say OFM. And Father Rigo is the parochial vicar at St. Joseph in York, Pennsylvania. And he flew in to come here. And Father Rigo is another priest from the Cameroonian Catholic community. So thank you for coming, Father. And last but not the least, the man who always reminded me to call him Father, but don't forget that he's a Monsignor. My father, Monsignor Henry Petter. Monsignor just retired as the pastor of St. Anne's Catholic Church in Coppell this past June. And so I thought, while you're the retired man at home, he should come and join us. So he came. Thank you so much for being here, Monsignor. And our Deacon John and Robert, thank you so much for gracing us with your presence and your help. And our altar service. And when Father said, parents, some of your kids are already dribbling away, I turned and asked Marty, I said, are you dribbling away? She says, well, I'm here, aren't I? So thank you all so much, server. Eugene is one of our seminarians on pastoral year. Thank you so much for being here, Eugene. Thank you all so much. And we have I'm told by Ma Mary Takwa, the chairperson of the Cameroonian Catholic community, that there is a hearty reception in store for us in the parish hall. You just go out this door, down the hallway, the hall is right there. So all of you are invited to join us to celebrate this great day. Father Arthur, please tell the bishop, one, he is in our prayers during this difficult time. Many of us know what it means to lose a mother. And tell him he's in our prayers, and we love him very much. And we pray for the repose of his soul, of the soul of his mother, Mrs. Geraldine Burns, and that we look forward to seeing him here next spring. And tell him also that we thank him. We know how much love he has for this community and how much he has been encouraging us to gather together, that we really appreciate his leadership and being the pastor that he has been to us. So tell him we miss him and we'll keep him in our prayers. Thank you. Same to Bishop Kelly. So thank you all very much.
African God. He's become an honorary African already, so we're going to keep him. We're going to keep him. But my dear friends, what a joy today, huh? What a joy for y'all to have this wonderful community. Know that you are in our prayers and in our thoughts, and please do invite us back. Invite us back, all the priests here, to come back and worship with you anytime. I know the bishop can't wait to come back and be with this community. So thank you for everything, and may God bless each and every one of you. Please rise. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorify our Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
To God be the glory,
great things he has.